Hey everyone, this is Nitro. So I'm continuing on with the playthrough in the Battle Brothers Desert Blazing Deserts Let's Play of the Manhunters campaign. So far it's been quite some time. There's been 31 days past now, and in this campaign so far my party has steadily grown over time. Now, there were a few battles where I lost major numbers of soldiers or characters, but due to the way the Manhunters work, where you get one new in-depth for every battle against other human soldiers, it allowed me to rebuild my party pretty easily, to the point where I now have 21 out of 25 characters, most of which are in-depth. I currently have reached Tenweir, finishing a quest here, and so with that quest completion, I actually see that a bunch of my characters have leveled up. So let's just get them upgraded. For example, this guy can get some extra melee attack skill, some extra melee defense skill, and he does have iron lungs, so in that sense, fatigue is probably less important for him, but I still think it's... you have to get some fatigue because of higher level armors really require you to have good fatigue. So with those upgrades complete, I'm going to start by getting Pathfinder on him. And on the other guy here, which is one of my actual recruits, let's give him 3 melee attack, 4 stamina, and then I can choose 2 hit points or 2 range defense. I guess 2 range defense. It's pretty terrible choices for that last stat. And perk-wise, once again, I am going to be starting with Pathfinder. So there we are. Currently have a lot of gold on hand. 2,000. But my priority right now is to get good gear for everyone before I consider recruiting expensive heroes. So I'm going to mostly stick with in-depth and get good gear for my characters instead of recruiting more. It's definitely an interesting playstyle, very different from a lot of the other factions. Oh, there's a cheap armor, 75 armor for 100, so I'll definitely buy that one. And I don't see anything else that is really worth purchasing, so I'll continue to save up in an attempt to get more reinforced mail hauberks. The priority for getting that hasn't really changed from the past. So take a look at some of these guys. I think everyone in the back line now has 75 defense armors. And everyone in the front pretty much has the 65 defense ones. So in that sense, at this point, I don't really need to buy any more 75 defense armors, because I'm going to jump up to the 210 for heroes now. So it looks pretty good. Just keeping an eye out on the stores to see if there's anything else worth purchasing. Right? Sword lances seem like they're pretty interesting weapons, but I don't think I'd buy one. It's like the pole mace. You know, I wouldn't buy these weapons, but if I get them, I'll happily equip them. Beyond that, I think I'm gonna give my first attempt at the arena. So for this battle, what am I facing against? 3 Gnash Slashers. Okay, we'll slaughter them. Which is the Gnashin. Okay. So I'm gonna find 3 heroes to equip those items on, which should probably be this guy, for sure. And I think my sergeant would be a good choice, although I want a better repaired armor on him. And then the third character, let's make it another frontliner if possible. But I don't think I have very many good frontliners at this time. The deserter, I guess, is probably amongst the best ones. Yeah. So let's just give him that helmet and then give him the third one. And let's head into the arena. We're gonna just place him here, have this guy move up, and kill him. So he has 210 defense armor, which means he, and with the shield, he's pretty darn hard to kill. Let me just smack him, move in. Guy with the 90 defense. Not much good. So I guess I'll whip him. And with enough hits, he was forced into a routing mode, allowing my sergeant to easily kill. And that gave me some experience. So there we go. Arena victory. Earned a bunch of gold for it, you know. Definitely should do more of these arena fights. I just keep forgetting about it. But it certainly helps. Alright, so I think that's everything I want to do in this location. I'm not looking to hire anyone, I'm looking to build up gold. So let's move on. You can take what he wants. Let's just help him. And he gave us some free items. Yeah, so if I look into this area, right, it shows, I guess, the people who died in my party. You can see there's a lot of them. 14 characters died so far. This is definitely a very, very different style of play. My favorite enemies. There's also a nomad leader. That's new. So let's engage them. Oh, this might be ugly. Outlaws and all that. They're running in. Oh, there's the nomad leader. Guess I have to be willing to sacrifice characters to succeed here. But let's just retreat these guys back for now. Shield wall him. Wait. And also wait. And he's gonna just run up. one, two, three, four to here. So I'm going to just think shield wall here. Also shift down. Move forward. And start hitting him. Two ranged enemy right away. Wow! One shot it. But it doesn't really surprise me anymore. I'm going to wait. Wait. Also wait. Whippings, whippings. Ow. He is hitting everything with his two-hander. Why does that never happen for me? Well, in any case, let's wait. Stab and shift. Let's wait. So I need to kill. But I'm missing like crazy. Oof. Oof. Uh-oh. I think he's dead. Because he's losing health. Good. That guy's forced to retreat. Find them some other weapons. Other than these ranged weapons. And because I don't have a band-aid, he's gonna bleed to death. I think. See? Yeah, gonna cut neck vein is gonna kill him. Yep. Oh, I didn't even get the weapon of that guy, too. That sucks. I think the leader had a unique weapon, so I didn't even loot that. Lost 3 characters, level 1, level 2, level 4. AD armor, some of these helmets, and yeah, no unique weapon. That's a shame. Well, take what I can get. And get the new recruits. Throw on the armor on him. He really is nothing special, but what can you do? Just use who you have available. That's pretty much it. Longer sure if I still want flails. It's one of the things I've been wondering. Well, at least 2 guys have the ability to switch to scimitars if necessary. I'm gonna have to look at giving these guys war forks. This is 70 to 95 damage. These are, yeah. Huge difference there, 60 to 75 versus 75 to 90. So the long axes are still much better than these pull maces. Although the pull maces have the ability to knock, to stun enemies. These ones only have 50 to 70, but 2 movement is a big advantage. Okay, so my sergeant has leveled up, so more resolve, 2 more attack, and 4 more range defense. think I'm gonna get Fortified Mind for him. Right? To maximize his resolve. And he can get more attack. More stamina. More hit points. He's really not that great. But... given the circumstances, it's what I've got. Alright, so, 3. Four stamina. I guess 3 hit points. And this guy still, I don't know what I'm gonna do with him. So we'll leave it as is. Hold on. Do I actually have? No, I'm missing a character in my battle line. Minus 10 resolve, minus 5 melee skill versus minus 10 resolve will never be in confident morale. Is the way to equip it. So I did hit 2850 crowns, which means I could buy the armor, but two-star mission. If you can trust it. Yeah, I guess I'll accept it. After all, nomads have been what I've been fighting anyways. In terms of selling of items, I don't think this is the best location because I haven't done quests here for some time. We'll accept this contract. Take a look at faction relations, right? Holy City of Tenuir, right? Likes me a lot more than Hikma. That's why I've been doing... oh, and so does New Ditch. Anyways. This place actually has an armorer too. 200 defense for 2800. That's very similar to the Hauberks that I've been buying actually, right? The Hauberks are 2850 for 210. So I'll probably pick one up once I have a bit more gold on hand. Weapon wise, it's not worth purchasing compared to the armors, in my opinion. Now I know that this place has an armor too. Interesting. It's just here that doesn't. So there's an armorer here. Maybe I will sell some stuff so I have enough crowns to last for the next day. So if I sell the flail, I'll have enough crowns right there. But I'm selling it for significantly lower than I could. Let's just be patient then. Mentioned I don't need any more 75 defense armors because I'm already using mostly 65 and so on. Everyone has these 60 defense shields, so they're very hard to break. And we just move to the next location. Let's just go for it. As much as I want that 210 defense armor or 200 defense armor, I think now is not quite the time. 11 nomads just left. So I think this is the time to clear this location, isn't it? Sixteen versus 9, yeah. Going to move my archers. Wait. 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 Backline guys are all waiting. There we go. Nice. Yeah, I'm gonna retreat this guy at this point. Nice. It's not worth sacrificing this guy, I don't think. Seems like I got into this location at the perfect time. Since there weren't too many defenders. Cheers. On him, finish him, just one archer left to kill. Which is gonna kill itself, I think. There we go. Three more level ups, no characters lost. Several scimitars received, another pole mace. No armors though, but can't complain. He goes into the reserve list. The next guy shows up. And he'll carry probably the same weapon. Same spear. Iron Lung guy leveled up. So. Three more melee skill. Three more melee. Four more? Okay. Pathfinder, student, Brawny. Going to give him sword mastery so that he can just endlessly swing that sword. Without losing any stamina at all. He could carry this as a side weapon, but I think the sword will be a better option. In most cases. And this archer leveled up, so 2 and 4. I guess 3. Perk-wise, he has the fast adaptation, Pathfinder. I guess I'll make him a student for now. I just want to double check my equipment, right? This guy's armor is useless right now. So maybe replace that and repair this. before I get into combat, make sure everyone is actually capable of combat. I'll rotate him in. And find him as weapon. Flail would be good. No, sword. Scimitar. Given this guy is asthmatic, or he has asthma. So I like the fact most of my guys now have scimitars as their reserve weapons though. Good enough. Let's move in. Need some nomad slingers. And an outlaw. You know what? I don't think it's worth it. Or maybe it is. I do need... So this will be the final fight before I... For... I guess... This video. This one actually... This battle is already taking... This video is already 40 minutes. I didn't expect it to take to go through so much time in this battle. 16 versus 11. Let's just wait for them to move up initially. Wow, 1, 2, 3. More slingers than I expected. All right, so they're not moving. Presumably because they have more slingers than I do. Spoke too soon. They moved in a little. Yep, here they come. Here we go. Take them down. These nomads all seem to apply that special effect on me. It's okay. That was okay, though. I'm gonna have my backlines wait for now. Missing every strike now. Fortunately, they are too, or else this would turn into a nightmare again. There we go. Looks good. Kill them all. Probably totally unnecessary. I'm just doing unnecessary damage to my characters at this point. Yeah, let's just kill them. There we go. More nomad slings, another pull mace. And Reinforced and an Adept. Probably the most important part. 55 attack in depth. This one's actually pretty good. He has some melee defense, he has a good attack value. More hit points than most of my backline guys had. The only question I have now is, should I be rotating some of these guys to the front line? Right? Because if I can... I don't know. But let's swap him out. This guy has very low stats. By comparison. So he's on the side, this guy's in the center or closer to the middle. So the three middle guys are guys that are good. He's also a good character. So actually, I should probably switch the helmet. These two are mediocre ones. 1, 2, and 3. Oh, he leveled up. So 57 attack, 4 hit points, and 3 stamina. Finder to start. Back to Hikma. $740. Yes. The Indept Uprising. Might as well do it. Oh crap. I was supposed to end this video, but I'm continuing, aren't I? I can't even catch them. And I know I have to do this because I'm gonna forget otherwise. So I wanna finish this. This is gonna be a longer video than usual. Oh, it's not in depth. They're nomads. Okay. So this will be the last part. Definitely the very last part of this. These are some pretty well equipped in depth. Move my front lines first. I think I'm going to have him be careful. Because he's already... his armor is damaged and he is hurt. Thank you. start the whippings. Just that buff. Let's hold in position for now. Let's see what they do. In they come. I'll take it. Swing at him. Wait. Cheers. Hit one of those shots. Oh, come on. This is... Lift up by their archers, actually. Oh. Down goes one guy. I think that was the new recruit. Backline misses like this, it starts becoming a nightmare. They're all missing. Well, looks like my frontliners are dying yet again. Wow, I haven't been able to hit this guy. It's like 8 strikes, they all missed. Nightmare. Finally. Looks okay. Or not. I thought I could keep him alive. And then that happened. The whip. Perfect. So he should actually kill himself because he's bleeding right now. But just to be safe, I think I'll attack him. Switch over to a warfork. Same with him. Twelve characters. Did I lose four? Hold on. Let's see. 1, 2, 3. Okay. That's still pretty bad. Level 3. Level 1. And level 4. Oh no. Oh well. I mean, you have to expect losses if you're using characters with a high level armor, like 200 armor. So, not too surprised about these losses at the end of the day. Yeah, this was a longer battle than usual. And I'll take the in-depth. So I'm just gonna head to Hikma, and that will be it for this playthrough. Ended up being double the time of how much I normally want to make these playthroughs. In any case, thanks for watching, everyone. Nitro out.